Dr. Norbert Gleich, and I'm the medical director of CHR and its chief scientist. Among the many questions which are pouring into CHR, whether through our website or by other means, one of the most frequently asked questions is, how come that even donor egg IVF cycles fail? And this is obviously a very, very good question to ask, because donor egg cycles are indeed by far the most successful IVF cycles. Doesn't matter to what other IVF practice you compare it. Nothing beats the pregnancy and live birth rates of a donor egg cycle. And the reason is, in principle, because the age of the egg is the single most important determining factor, not only in spontaneous conceptions, but also in conceptions in pregnancies after or in association with various fertility treatments. The reason is simple. The younger an egg, the better it functions. And it is what I have come to call the only biological disadvantage women have over men. Eggs are finite. Women are born with all of their eggs, and therefore those eggs, in the very primitive form in which they initially exist in the ovary over many, many years. And they obviously, at least to some degree, age during that time and lose functional ability to lead to pregnancy. So it's all in the egg. And we men are really quite unimportant in this whole process, because we men constantly produce fresh sperm, and therefore Charlie Chaplin could still become a father at age 82. That doesn't mean that the sperm of an 82-year-old is as good as the sperm of a 25-year-old male, but because it is still fresh, freshly produced, it is certainly still able to produce a good offspring, even at advanced ages. So how come then that even though the pregnancy chances at young ages are so high, not all IVF cycles lead to pregnancy? And the answer is, once again, in nature. Think about it. Even a couple at peak fertility in their early 20s who are perfectly healthy, have no medical problems, on average, need 3 to 4 months to conceive. One can assume that in those 3 months, that couple produces an embryo, because if the woman has no health problem, if she has regular cycles, she will produce an egg in every cycle. The man's, if he is young and has normal functions, will provide adequate sperm. Sperm and egg will meet, an embryo will be created, and yet still it takes 3 to 4 months for such a couple at peak fertility to conceive. This means that not every embryo has even the capacity to implant and to lead to normal pregnancy. Even in best patients, even in youngest patients. And that obviously also applies to young donors. We here at CHR select donors very, very carefully. And yet, still, as in many other centers, only a certain percentage of these donor eggs end up leading to pregnancy. To be more specifically, If we transfer a single embryo, it's under 50%. If we're transferring two embryos at a time, it may be at as much as 65% in terms of clinical pregnancy rates. But that still leaves a large chunk of IVF cycles with young donor eggs, with young carefully selected donor eggs that do not result in pregnancy. And the reasons are exactly the same as in that young couple I described to you before, who need 3 to 4 months to conceive. Not every even great-looking embryo from the healthiest parents, not every embryo has the potential of leading to pregnancy. We believe that that is the main reason why even with egg donation, not all cycles work. Besides, there are obviously other reasons. There can be an implantation problem. There can be an implantation problem that we cannot diagnose. And there may be an implantation problem related to uterine abnormality or some other abnormalities that affect the implantation process. But we believe that the majority of failed cycles are really due to the embryo not being able to implant, because even though those embryos may look perfectly healthy, when we inspect them through the microscope, functionally, they are simply not able to do it. So there's no big difference between a failure in a donor egg cycle and not getting pregnant when a healthy couple is deciding to want to have a child or another child. And just as that couple usually doesn't get upset if they don't get pregnant in the first month, you should also not get upset if you don't get pregnant in the first donor cycle. The chances of getting pregnant with young donor eggs are so high that sooner or later there's an overwhelming likelihood that you will be pregnant. Thank you.